Hey everybody, it's Evicta. It's time to continue eating streak here in the Binding of Isaac Evicta Afterbirth Plus series. Thank you everybody for getting the like streak counter back on target, as not only yesterday's video has already crossed, but the day before is as well. Thank you all very much. Indeed, we are almost halfway through to the Sissy Mod. Here's your meme of the day brought to you by Zake Ruga or Zake Ruga. I'm not exactly sure how to enunciate it or pronunciate it, but it's from the Invicta subreddit, of course. Everyone during the Mega Stand fight. Indeed. Thank you very much, Zake Ruga. Ruga. I'm pretty sure it's got to be Ruga. That sounds like an MMA fighter name or something. I don't know. Something like that. Today is going to be 2 Charlie 8 Foxtrot Yankee Bravo Charlie X-Ray. We've got ourselves a Void start here with Great Tears, Papa Fly. Pretty decent shot speed. Not great movement speed, but not terrible either. And negative luck, which is okay. Yeah, we had a very not-so-great run on stream tonight. It was a run that was pretty much plagued by nothing but just... Let's put it this way. We got one stat up until the chest. That was it. And it was a damage upgrade that we got on floor, I think, 5. And we literally got nothing else after that. So, thankfully, with the Void... Why we don't like followers... although that may have been one of my shots. I don't know. I'm going to blame the follower anyway. Either way, with Void here, we don't have to worry about not being able to get stats. Because obviously we can just simply create our own stats. And what I mean by that is we essentially, anytime we find an item pedestal that we simply don't want, we can use the Void, assuming that it's not a space bar item, and we can just Void it, consume it, and that's going to turn it into passive stats for us. So that gives us hope. It gives us plenty of hope. There's double super jump. We've got to be careful of that. So you're going to watch. You're going to see me essentially bait out the jumps here from the spiders. And again, you can manipulate the positions of when those spiders lock onto your current position. And then once you play the game long enough, you will be able to anticipate when they're going to jump. So they will fixate on your last known location to them and then jump at that location. And it's very easy to manipulate them and to goad them into jumping after you when you know that there's no possible way in heck that they're going to be able to hit you. Yeah, so Betrayal is definitely going to be one of those items. Backstabber is not terrible, admittedly, but I'd rather not have it. I'd rather have the Tears upgrade and the shot speed up that we got from it than actually have Backstabber. And, of course, Void is also going to allow us to turn it into whatever space bar item we want. So if we do happen to find a space bar item that we like, say, Book of Revelations or a Book of Shadows, something along those lines, we will be able to add that to the Void's repertoire. And essentially, Void becomes whatever type of space bar item you want it to be, on top of being able to convert passive items that you don't want into stats, into raw stats. Which is why I always go on record saying that Void is one of, if not the best, space bar item, period, because it does everything. I mean, Void does it all. Literally. Got ourselves a Lime Horn. Now, with our shot speed and a 6-tier delay, this is going to be pretty easy sailing throughout most of this run, I would say. At least the early stages. 3.93 damage, of course, is way over our normal average stats. And whenever people have been asking me, what do I consider to be average? What do I consider to be, you know, optimal or above average strat, etc., or start, I should say. And it's comparatively speaking to base Isaac. So Isaac's base damage on any given run is 3.5. That is the base Isaac damage. And when I say base Isaac, I mean literally just Isaac, the one that starts with the D6. That is where you're going to take all of. I will take the range upgrade here. That is the stat value that everything else is weighted against. So whenever I'm comparing a start, like saying like, oh, this is a subpar start, or oh, this is a great start, that is what I'm that's what I'm weighing against. Let's see here. We do have a Tinted Rock. Of course, I'd love to get the double bombs. Unfortunately, we cannot access that right now. I should also mention that this video, I think, is still going to be in 720p, talking about the native resolution here. I don't know why OBS is capturing at 720. It's I have no idea. My settings have remained the same forever. I did revert OBS's settings to an old version of OBS, which that was the whole part of like me trying to tweak the system and trying to get the stuttering to stop. Of course, that didn't work at all. And then I re-upgraded to the most recent OBS version, and it saved all my settings that I used to have. I have it all loaded up into my OBS profile, so I don't know why it's all of a sudden capturing at 720. I don't know. I have no earthly clue how this computer works at this point. I'm planning on. I don't know who I'm going to go with for the next computer. Now that the taxes have kind of taken a big hit, considering that I couldn't. I did get the refund from Digital Storm, by the way. It finally came in, and they refunded me fully. So I'm not going to tell them thanks, because I would have much rather had my computer, but you know, that's neither here nor there. I don't know who exactly I'm going to go with yet. Some people have been recommending Origin. Some people have been saying NZXT. I will say, for the record, when I was doing some background checking into Origin, they did not impress me. I've seen some not so great reviews of their machines. Let's get our other stat up here. By other stat up, I mean get our tiers cap. Ooh, Pandora's box on this floor. I don't remember what it does. 2 bombs, 2 keys, apparently. Man, this is tough. We are going to take empty vessel. I don't remember if we've gone into the secret room here. We have not. We haven't even found the store. Now that we have flying, because we have empty vessel, let's go do a little bit more exploring here. The empty vessel is going to give us flying as long as we have 0 red heart containers. Of course, it also has that invincibility shield that is generated by us every 40 seconds or so, something like that. Great chest there. Even more moolah here. The half red hearts, by the way, are given to us from our trinket, which is the bloody penny. But I would have loved to have taken the Book of Sin, because that's a fantastic item for us to have, while also having a void, but it didn't happen. And we get restock, and lucky for us, we also have a half price item in here. The restock is going to allow us to infinitely get items from the store as long as we can pay for it. It's going to refresh the shop items. And what's nice about this store in particular is that we have a half price premium item for 7 cents, which means that it's only going to cost us 7 cents to start scrolling through some good items in there. There is a donation machine, of course, but the problem is that we got rid of our red heart container, so the bloody penny is literally worthless. Apparently, that was also a champion. So we can't really go hard on this one. We can use a bomberino, though. Or not. You may say, well, you could have just played the IV bag or the temperance machine for like a couple of hits and then bought the blue hourglass. But the problem is that the glowing hourglass isn't... We're not going to be able to afford anything after that. Secret room should be to the left of here. Maybe there's some more money in here, or a counterfeit penny would be amazing, and we get it. Okay. So, we're not going to go hard on this floor, but definitely the next floor if we get some red hearts or any money at all. Get free entrance in here into the curse room here. I say free because it only costs you half, and then of course they teleport it out via the moon card, which saves us for another half. Did that to prove a point, by the way. So many people are like, you can fly behind the statues and they will never hit you. They still will hit you if they're shooting. It doesn't matter if you go in front of them or behind them. You still have to avoid the shots. So, just so you're aware. Try to educate Isaac players as much as I can. Just like we had. Oh, man. That tried poop is interesting, especially if we can somehow get... If we can somehow find, miraculously find, a card against humanity on this floor, we are set. Because then we're talking about almost unlimited money. And on top of that, we also have restock. Best case scenario would be there's a Steam sale inside the store, of course. And then maybe we would try one time to double for it. Like if we ended up getting the Crooked Penny, but... let's fight the boss while we're already here. It's unlikely we're going to get a devil deal, but I'm going to try it anyway. I will say that telekinesis was a huge, huge factor in winning today's run on stream. So telekinesis guy, you would have been proud. A lot of people were very impressed with how strong telekinesis is. So telekinesis is a 10-10, is an absolute 10-10 defensive item. It gives you almost absolute defense. And what I mean by that is that it gives you almost enough defense to where it is impossible for the enemies to hit you. It's still possible because there's a little bit of a downtime in between the casts. But man, let me tell you something. Telekinesis is legit. That is a legit item that is very, very good. Now, unlike Spirit of the Night, which it looks like that we have right now, we do not have an associated Spectral Tears. Awesome. Great to see a half-price item here. Fortunately, it was not the one we wanted. I am going to Void Candle. I don't think that Voiding Candle actually lets you shoot a candle shot, though. But, I mean, we might as well. We could have maybe held out for maybe like a D6 or a Perthrower Rune or something like that. I mean, theoretically, yes, I didn't have to void the candle right there, but I just did. I just did just so we don't have to worry about the item pedestal getting in the way and whatnot. Halo Flies is excellent. Way too good not to have. And Tapeworm, honestly, is excellent as well, but not what we need right now. We don't need range, and we certainly don't need shot speed. I would much rather have Counterfeit Penny, especially due to the fact that we have the we have restock. We are highly motivated to hold on to Counterfeit Penny. Of course, the compass did show us here that there's a mini boss down here. I'm hoping that it's greed. Not greed. Would have been nice if it was. The virus is our second syringe item. That is going to lower our movement speed again. But that's okay, and we're going to head on down. I'm not going to play the shop anymore. It's a shame that we can't take the petrified poop, but they love you. We might as well try it. Might be here. Not there. Could be here. If it's not there, then it could be... Huh. All right, well, I give up. Had a bunch of new people come on over from YouTube to the Twitch Mosh Pit to support the stream and try to get us into that that sub goal of getting the Isaac speed racing mod. Speed running mod. I say speed racing, but it's basically speed racing, speed running. It's the same thing. I'm not exactly sure how my knowledge is going to translate over to the speedrunning world. I don't think it's going to do that well. But I'm looking forward to it. I would love to hit that that sub goal on Twitch. It's a pretty massive milestone. We've never had the most Twitch subs we've ever had, I believe, was 1,330, something like that. And that was last year. It's been a while. But what would be cool would be hitting that 1,600 mark and then getting not only a new emote slot, but getting, of course, a new emote. And on top of that, playing some speedrunning mod for y'all. That's the thing that I'm looking forward to the most. I'm going to bomb this keeper for a little bit of extra odds there on the devil deal. Not that it's going to matter anyway, of course, but, you know, here's the hoping. Void Bobby bombs. We got more shot speed and more luck. I don't like homing bombs at all. They require... They're too finicky to throw down, and they're not reliable at all. And we need to go back to the shop. Which is most likely going to be a greed fight, since we have not seen a mini-boss fight this floor yet. Well, we got a full charge. Let's fight the boss first. Ooh, it's going to be the Fallen. Well, the Fallen has a chance of dropping... I mean, it's a guaranteed Devil Deal drop. It could drop anything. Hopefully it drops something useful. The pact would be nice. I would take Mom's Knife. I would take Brimstone, of course. I would take Abadab Ding Dong. Maw the Void showed up earlier today. Or it could give us nothing. All right. Fantastic. Fantastic. We get yet more shot speed, but we finally got some damage, thankfully. So we took an item that didn't have much value, if any, to us in the form of Headless Baby and turned it into a damage upgrade and a shot speed upgrade. And now our shot speed is getting a little out of control. 1.73 is pretty darn fast. I believe that means that your shots travel one... Right now, our shots are traveling one and almost three quarters of a tile per second, which is pretty fast. I think that's what that's measured in, but don't quote me on that. That's just that's an educated guess. But we do get Steam Sale. Of course, I'm not going to avoid it, but Steam Sale is pretty huge. I'm going back and looking for a full charge. We may do the boss trap room. Maybe, maybe not. I forgot that we have the virus as well. The virus is one of those items that I always forget that we have. It's just like host hat. It's just like when he goes power. If I, assuming that I go... everyone knows that I like to go to the vanity mirrors to change Isaac's look. Because there's some that, you know, are distracting or it just looks dumb. And sometimes when I do that, especially with Pyromaniac, Host Hat, Money Equals Power, it's easy for me. It's sort of like an out-of-sight, out-of-mind thing. Curse of the Lost here, unfortunately. Our compass is going to be a total waste. But that's okay, because we'd be looking for the store anyway. Now, you would think that me recording at 720p would keep the CPU usage down and the encoding demands down, but oh no. Those freezes you're seeing are indeed high encoding errors. Avoided Curse Eye into something useful here. We went straight to the boss again. I mean, we might as well. Super Secret Room is probably to the right of here. Yeah. All right. Now, thankfully for us, we can handle Mask of Infamy fairly easy because of one very important stat that we have plenty of, which is shot speed. Shot speed is everything when you're talking about non-poison effects against Mask of Infamy. You have to have the movement speed to effectively dodge all of its attacks, and then you also have to have the movement speed to get behind it. And then the shot speed is important so you can hit it in the back while it's running away from you. So you can make these kind of slick diagonal shots. To deal with the devil. I do not want an HP upgrade at this point. A red heart HP upgrade anyway. Right over here. Even when I'm like, hey, we'll straighten it up. We're gonna change things up a bit. Throw the game for a loop. It's like, no, you're still gonna run into a dead end. And having a lot of fun playing the RimWorld expansion. It's very, very good so far. The Nobles expansion. Royalty expansion, whatever you want to call it. I did also play a new game called Stone Shard, which I'm sure many of you are familiar with. And I was disappointed that you can't create your own character yet. I thought that you could create your own after the prologue, but it turns out you can't create it in the beta period. You have to wait until, I guess, 2021 when the game comes out. So that was a little bit of a downer, but it's a great game so far. It's as hardcore as Darkest Dungeon. It's easy to understand to the point of, like, it doesn't confuse an imbecile like me. And it's somewhat realistic, if dark fantasy is realistic. Oh my goodness, we get the de-sizzle. Now, here's the problem with this. The problem with the D6 is that it doesn't do well when you're talking about voiding something. There is no reason for you to void the D6 ever. Man, this is tough. I think, honestly, I truly believe that the D6 is the better call here. I really do. The reason being is that we're about to be on Necropolis 2, right? So we're only going to have one more floor of use out of our spacebar item before it's just done. And we haven't really used Void and voided any useful spacebar items. Again, anything that rerolls stuff is almost completely worthless to void. You're essentially exhausting the item pool without even trying, just from trying to give yourself some extra stats, which is the reason why you have to be so picky about which items you actually do void. The D6, I would argue, in this spot, where we haven't had that many integrations, if any, of any spacebar item in the game with our current void, gives the D6 in this situation gives us more opportunities to win. And it gives us a greater variety of items to roll through, rather than, well, this is going to go to a passive stat that we don't need, like shot speed right now, or, you know, range. You know what I mean? Like, I would much rather have an active item pedestal with an item on it that I can reroll versus, like, have, like, a 1 in 5 chance of getting a stat or stats that I really, really, really want. So that's my logic there. Some people are going to disagree with that. I don't necessarily disagree with you, but I'm just trying to formulate an explanation as to why I think the way that I do. I wasn't bombing there for a devil deal chance. I was bombing there to get the nickel from the keeper. But we have 41 cents in a Steam sale. Yeah, starter deck is excellent here. We're looking for a half-price premium item. We want half-price premium items here. Black Candaloo. Well, hang on. Oh. That's what I'm talking about. All right. We get some Victor robes. I will buy the Book of Belial, since I think this is our second book that we've touched, I think. And that is not Juice the Shadow. That is my shadow, which I'm just going to leave there. Ace of Hearts doesn't do anything for us. But here's the kicker now. Because we have... Temperance. Because we have a Temperance Machine, and we have a Steam Sale. Well, not Steam Sale. Well, I mean, yes, Steam Sale, but also because we have the Counterfeit Penny. Essentially, we can pay for unlimited money here, thanks to Restock and Soul Hearts. But again, more importantly, thanks to Counterfeit Penny, because we're technically able to make more money than we're going to be spending on refills for our hearts. But right now, you notice that we have more money than what we started with, and we have way more HP. And again, that is a direct result of having the counterfeit penny. So effectively, we create more money than we're using to refill, and that is our infinite loop. At 99 cents. Go ahead and refill real quick, just in case if there's no more soul hearts. There we go. Alright, I'll buy those options. We don't really want the dull razor blade. I'm willing to roll through this. Sharp plug. Mr. Slot Machine, you need to get out of here. Okay. I am going to take the full charge, but not use it yet. Guarding against humanity, it's almost not worth it at this point. In fact, I'm going to say it's not worth it. Trinket smelter, half price premium item. Here we go. Now we're talking. Humbling Bundadu. Charge baby. Champion belt, blanky. Mom's key. Glowing hourglass, which we will not use. Same thing goes for Ventricle Razor. Same thing goes for Mr. Me. Moving box. We could take the moving box. Full converter, no thanks. The treasure map as well. It's like it's going to give us the map compass effect. All right, so I'm going to reroll this now. Before we do that, let's use, because we're going to lose the IV bag here. Yeah, with Humbling Bundle, this makes it impossible for us to run out of money. But I am going to reroll the IV bag, though, no matter what. It just gives us another item pedestal. And we're probably not going to go through 33 items here. I guess I could take Buddy in a box. There's no real reason for us to re-roll the IV bag, I guess. School bag, not a huge fan of, but I will take it. Mystery gift gives us the 9-volt. Broken stopwatch. Mom's coin purse. Of course, we have starter deck, so it means that we don't have to worry about... Ooh, and we get Mom Omega. We can use that for the next floor. Sackhead, boomerang, car battery is not what we really wanted, but I'll take it. Rubber cables is great. Ooh. Well, actually, it doesn't matter if we get... Ooh, that's good. It doesn't really matter if we get Little Baggy, because this isn't a blank card run, so in a rare instance, I will take Little Baggy. Super duper rare, though. An Emperor card, awesome.
The Magician.
Deep Pockets. Coupon. The Jar. Bogo Bombs. Compost is great. Box of Friends is awesome. Spider Mod is whatever. Jar of Flies. There's Blank Card, which we probably won't use. There's Diplopia. Fortunately, Jar of Flies is over the... Diplopia. Okay, so here's what I'm thinking. Use moving box. going to pack all that up. And we're going to do something with it later. Arrow cloth. There's chaos. Okay. We're going to have to get a full charge. I need to get the IV bag out to get chaos. Or it's been rerolled. Okay. All right. You know what? I think I'm just going to hold off on doing that. I am going to take chaos, though. I mean, we have so much HP, I don't worry about running into a fire. We get chaos. It's going to shuffle all of our loot tables now. His tail that we can buy here. Excuse me. Oh, I bought the freaking... Raz again. I bought the tarot card when I wasn't trying to. There we go. Fate we really actually don't want. Okie dokie. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to do this. Cannot move. I cannot move. Okay. Then... Trust me, I'm going somewhere with this, trust me. You just have to trust me here. Of course, we got modem lag, which is going to make it seem like our game is broken. Of course, I'm going to be unaffected because I'm used to the stuttering at all times. Okay. I'm not going to go around look for an opportunity just to get a couple extra charges. There's blue fires here that I can't destroy. We're going to do that, right? We're going to spit everything out. We're going to come over here. Excuse me. And we're going to do this. Okay, now I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, why are you doing this? Here's why, friends. Because Diplopia just made us a whole lot more item pedestals that we can utilize. Alright? So, again, you might be asking yourself, why are you doing all this? Well, you'll have to wait a little bit, but I will show you why I did all that. Of course, chaos is also going to screw this up a little bit, so, you know, take that for what it's worth. But there is a reason why, and I will show you soon. Yeah, Book of Revelations, why not? It's going to give us Bookworm. Gives us 2 soul hearts since we have the car battery, and we'll head on down. Okie dokie. They see the freezing there. Of course, we got a whole lot of everything from the store. We got Hive Mind, which is going to augment our damage. I mean, is this a one run? Yeah. I don't even think I need to quantify that question with an actual answer, but yes, this is a one run. Anytime we get a chance to break the game, it's going to probably end up being in one run status. And the way that we break it, we don't need a credit card, really. The way that we broke it here was very interesting. It's been a little bit since I've been able to break the game. I will take speed, Roid Rage. It's going to give us Spun. Okay, we might as well go into the shop here just to see what's in there. What was that? Gemini, you okay? Not entirely. Oh, you know why? It's King Baby. That's why. That's why Gemini's going crazy. It's because of King Baby. So King Baby freezes all of the familiars in their current position, but because Gemini is tethered to us, it gets gets a little wonky. Half Price Soul Heart, of course, we don't care about. Titanic Bibble. That sensor, I see it is. Sensor. I'm not going to take Mom's Knife at this point. I would have taken it earlier, but I don't think we need it now. Guppy's Head, okay. It's our second Guppy item. Keep in mind, this is a half-price premium item. It's Sad Bombs, Dead Bird, Bob's Curse. Where that ends right there. Mom's Eye, I guess. I will take Fast Bomb. Fast Bomb's actually pretty good. Host Hat's excellent. Rosary is acceptable. So now we have Explosion Immunity, which is amazing. And we get the Holy Grail, which is actually something I don't want, but I'm going to take or the Eucharist, not Holy Grail, sorry. Okay, so now that we have that, that's all I need. That's all I need. Now, because we have the Eucharist, that means that we're guaranteed angel deals from here on out. And now, in a weird way, this all comes back down to the Chaos. Because now, instead of Chaos hurting my potential strat here, it's actually helping us immensely. Now that we have the Eucharist. And some of you who are more experienced, you probably already see where I've been going with this. But essentially, the whole reason why we had that whole moving box thing go on is about to be revealed. The very particular reason why I wanted to do that. And this is why. That's not why, but this is why. So we go, yeah. And then we switch to here. And finally, we go, yeah. Now, whatever's over there, I'm not sure. But let's find out together, because that looks like a party that I want to be a part of. I mean, there's a whole lot of stuff over there. Now, remember, we have car batteries, so we've been rolling through stuff twice. But this looks like a party I can get down with. Maybe. Or I could also just re-roll it. I mean, I see Lord of the Pit. I see Guppy's Collar in there. Let's get... Yeah, let's get another reroll. I'm curious, you know. Okay, 9 lives. I will take the Halo Relic. How you doing? Good to see you. Eden's Blessing. I can go ahead and leave. Not really caring about that. Guppy's Collar. Sure. That is not Godhead in there, but we're gonna try to slip in here and just see what happens. I'm getting booted out. I'm starting to make headway. Hang on. It's all right. We got it. Don't worry. All right. Box. That's a box of stuff. Miter's great. Holy Grail. Breakfast. Okay. Breakfast. Quarter. Best bud. It's reward. No, thank you. But I mean, just, we don't really have a opportunity to be choosy here. I see Eden's soul in there as well. Cancer, that is not the, it's not the trinket, obviously. It's the passive item. We'll say it's very odd that the it's very odd that the item pedestals are still colliding with each other, but I can't actually know you what you know what we can walk out and walk back in. There we go. Whew. Okay. We got there. Alright. I will take Angelic Prism here. Just because I think it's an interesting item. I have a Sun card. We don't need anything else. I might as well take the Wooden Cross. And, yeah. We could reroll stuff. We might as well get Circle Protection while we're here. If you're wondering why I'm not taking Eden's Blessing, I've gone over this many times, but in case if you... Oh, good. In case if you didn't know, here's why. Essentially, it comes down to the fact that the more items you start a run with, the higher the chance is that you will get an unfavorable start. Yes, you could also say, well, yeah, but the same is true for good starts, which is true, yeah. It's the same odds of getting a good start, but it's also the same odds of getting a terrible start. You could let's put it this way, you have more chances of getting unwinnable combinations than you do at not. Now, of course, it's remote in terms of like how much do I actually believe that taking Eden's Blessing is possibly a threat to the streak. It's not that much of a threat, but again, it only takes one time for it to screw everything up. Skin out Mushroom actually doesn't do anything for us here. Neither does Eye of Belial, really. Okay. Going in a lot more chests here. That's fine by me. Book of Shadows. Eh. There we go. Crown of Light. We missed ya. Going to double our damage. Yeah, we'll take Gimpy. Might as well. Doesn't really matter at this point, though. Did I take the Polaroid or the negative? I hope I took the negative. I did not. I took the Polaroid. Dang it. Dang it. I just thought about that, too. I couldn't remember which one we had taken, but turns out I took the negative. Oh, well. We all know this was a broken run. Not from the start, but, I mean, as soon as we got restock, it was over. If we get a chance to fight Delirium, I absolutely will fight Delirium. People have been asking for a Delirium fight. I'm happy to reciprocate. And what you're seeing here is the result of us just destroying the game. And having a very, very high luck stat. That's the reason why you're seeing so many holy shots right now. Essentially, every single shot that we shoot has Cracked the Sky on it. Which is just... I mean, that's just sick, nasty, crazy. And if we do happen to take damage, of course... We also have Sad Bombs and Curse of the Tower. So if the game hits us once, I mean, good luck, game. Holy Mantidu. And I will take Evil Eyes. Well, Evil Eyes is actually pretty good here. Let's head on up. But what a fun run, though. You know, we didn't have a whole lot of expectations going into this run, other than the fact that we started off with pretty good stats. But here we are, 45 minutes later, and we've got ourselves a very powerful run. Very flashy run as well. I like the prism. There's something about the angelic prism that just exudes this sort of flashiness that you don't get to see really too much on other runs. I'm not saying it's the greatest item of all time, of course, but you know, the results speak for themselves. And again, because we have the double crown of power, crown of light. Crown of light gives us double damage, is what I meant to say. We're going to just smoke everything that is going to get in our way, yeah. Yeah, and I'm not gonna leave the chance. Let's go fight Delirium. He's been getting far too cocky. Thinking that he's above us. That we're not gonna go after him. Not today, buddy. Let's do it. No, chaos cards do not work. If you don't believe me, then, well, allow me to show you. Like I said, doesn't work. What a way. Get Dunk Delirium. We love it. Thank goodness for restock and Steam sale. And of course, knowing how awesome the moving box can be now. Taking item pedestals and re-rolling them to match the loot tables of other rooms. Of course, that again was thrown for a loop a little bit by Chaos, but we still had a lot of fun. If you enjoyed this video, click the like button. If you didn't, click the dislike button. Hope you all had a great start to your Friday. And again, thank you to those of you who've been filling out the post-video surveys. You've been posting screenshots of it on Reddit. I love seeing that stuff. Please continue to do that. I really would appreciate that. Hope you have a great start to your weekend. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody!